I've given the transmitter a boost. The reception should be improved.
Patch me through, Nana.
You've got it. You're connected. Go ahead, X.
Colonel Redips, do you read?
X, are you all right?
Yes, sir. And I'm not alone. We're building an anti-rebellion force.
Perfect. We have good news on this side as well. We've picked up a signal at point A6 on Giga City.
Zero? Zero's alive?
We've made momentary contact with Zero at point A6.
Point A6? Colonel? Colonel! Nana, get us some info on point A6.
Coming right up.
What is it?
Spider, where have you been?
I've been around. What's up?
Listen, everyone. Zero might... My friend might still be alive. He's...
Another Maverick Hunter? Excellent. We need all the help we can get.
Okay, so where is he?
Displaying point A6 on the monitor now.
From the looks of it, it appears to be heavily fortified.
Let's move out!
Zero! You're alive! What's going on, everybody? MetalBlade427 here, and I present to you Let's Play Mega Man X Command Mission. In the last episode, we finished Chapter 4, we beat Mad Nautilus, and we got a lot of new allies. Two of them that are actually on our team, and one that's just kind of a doctor that's in the background. So, in this episode, this is pretty much the intermission episode between now and 5. Before I actually begin it, I have something I want to say, and that would be happy anniversary to me! Yes, on this day to which this video is being uploaded, November 19th, will mark the 1-year point to which I started uploading videos on this channel. So, November 19th, 2013, I uploaded Battle Network 1, Episode 1. So, wow, it's been a whole year already, and here we are, 4 completed, well, I guess it'd be 4 1/3 command mission, I guess, completed runs so far. I mean, I know there's people out there that do a lot more in a year, but being that this is more of a hobby for me than anything, and, you know, it's a lot of fun regardless, I'm doing pretty good, and I have a lot more things ahead of me. So, why don't we get moving today? Let's go up here and talk to Miss Nana. We're actually going to open up the deployment center and see how our Reploids did in between the episode. Alright, here we go. So, we found a bunch of Megaloids during our last run through Chapter 4. That's why it says Deployable 3. So, if you remember, we found the Big Monkey, we found the Preon, and we found the Mator. So, we'll make sure to send them out today. But until then, let's see if everybody has come back with some good stuff. I'm not too sure about Central Tower. I think we just had Mr. Puppy in this one. Oh, wait, no. Oh, look at that. He leveled up to level 10. His search is perfect. He is now considered a Hall of Famer, which is why he has a little crown under his name instead of saying level 10. And we can't raise any more stats on him. So what he has is what he has. But he's really good. That's awesome. Came back with a bunch of interesting things. A figure token. Very nice. Some tower data. I believe that's music. And 218 Zenny. Sweetness. All right. Let's go to the Lungaro Ruins. And see how our team did. Shark came back, very nice, he's level 5. Alright, the Deer Ball came back level 2. And the Sign Dropper died. Oh. Well, 2 out of 3. I mean, we'll get better as they start leveling up. They'll all come back, you know, fully healed and ready to go. So, see how it goes. Another figure token, Hip Oppressor! Nice. Patrol Dog, alright, not bad, not bad. 520 Zenny, I shall take it. Okay. I am going to start with the Tiana camp. Now, just like the Lungaro Ruins, there is a special key that you can get in the Tiana camp. You can send your guys in order to go find it, and then you can go and open the door. But when you do that, I highly recommend you hang a left and not go right. There's actually 2 doors in there. One of them leads, I believe, to a tank part and another Mechaloid. I'll find that out once I actually get the key. But the other one leads to a boss battle, a hidden boss battle. And the boss within that room will make short work of whoever you have right now, because they are extremely powerful and we don't have anywhere near the good means in order to defeat them yet. They have a great prize for when you actually do defeat them, but that's not going to be for a while. However, as I said, I do want to send some people off on here in order to start collecting the stuff. I think I am going to... Now what do we got? A lot of items. So we want some of these guys. So why don't we actually send... Anything else good? Disc? Green? How about we do Mator? And Deer Ball?
And... Let's send a patrol dog with these guys. How do you think? I'm worried about them. Okay, that is not the way to do it. So why don't we deploy this team now? How about we put the patrol dog first? Deerball, Mator. Yeah? Better? Patrol dog? Still worried about them. Alright. Alright. Okay. That's fine. No. I want... How about the D-Shark? I want someone with a huge search, because there's a lot of items in there. Come on, this has got to be alright. You're still worried about them. Oh man, I'm sure they'll get experience. You know what, this is fine. Fine, away you go. If they come back dead, they come back dead. Womp womp to that. Let us go through... Let's do Central Tower. What do we got here? Search is going up, we need lots of items and lots of discs. Let us do... Prion's actually a really good leader. Then let's do Sign Dropper, and let's do Big Monkey. I hope you get good results. Alright, that's a pretty average thing for Nana to say. She's confident about this deployment. Awesome, very nice. I like it, and Langaro Ruins. I think we have Patrol Dog left. Should I send him there? Alright, sure, why not? Oh, he's worried. Aw, that's alright. Little guy, I trust your judgment. Okay, and that's that. And there we go. Disconnect. Very good. All right, so now we just got to go around and do what we got to do and come back and see how they are. Why don't we talk to our party members now, see what they all think about us, knowing that our friend Zero is alive. I know none of them have really met Zero, but they should. Everyone should meet Zero. Spider, what do you think? Zero. That's another famous Maverick Hunter. In my bounty hunting days, we would have been prime game. He would have been prime game. And now I'd prefer he join up with us. Yeah, me too, Spider. I hear that. Let us... I need to check something really quickly. Alright, all of us are good level. All of our hypers are good. Whoops. Get back in there. How's our sub-tanks? Full. Okay. Alright, let's go this way. There's more that I'm going to talk about. I am going to talk about Cinnamon. I am going to talk about the Force Metal Generator, but just other things I'm going to get done with first. Galdeal, what do you got to say?
This facility is pretty incredible, isn't it, X? Take that maintenance bed, for example. If you can overlook the bed altitude... The bad attitude, it does a great job of repairing the alien sub-tanks. With a field like these, we can really show off our stuff.
Oh, good. I'm glad that you're actually on board with us now, Galdeal. And what do your arms do exactly? Like, you're not really touching anything that's, you know, hazardous to a robot. Cinnamon, what do you think?
Oh, X. I'll try my very best. Please let me accompany you.
Of course, Sin. Of course I'm going to let you accompany me. Why wouldn't I? You are a vital asset to my team, hands down. And I know I haven't really explained why yet, but she is. She is. Trust me. Massimo, what do you got to say for yourself, my friend?
Professor Galdeal, Cinnamon, and Marino. We're lucky to have found so many friends. I hope we can find Zero, too.
Yeah, I hope we do, too. Because if Zero's on my team, then you know what? That's all you really need. You need Cinnamon, you need Zero, you need X, and you win everything.
Oh boy, resistance this, resistance that. I hope you get paid for overtime. But I do owe you one, and you saved Cinnamon. I'll agree to help you out, at least until I can repay you.
You'll be able to repay us plenty times over, Marino. So she's going to pretty much be there all the time in between chapters, so we'll go and we'll talk to her and see what she says every so often. And that being everybody, how about we head over to the square or the marketplace, or I keep calling it something it's not, but we're going to go get some items now. Airbus time, away! Alright, let me go into here. 27, alright, that's enough to get two full things, but I'm going to do that at the very end. How about we actually go here? I'm going to equip everybody with what I need to equip first, and then I will sit down and talk about all the new goodies we have, like the Force Metal Generator and Cinnamon. So, first off, let's talk to the Weapon Shop guy. We can buy the X-Buster Mark II, which I will buy. Now we can get Spider's King card, so we'll get the spades and we'll get the clubs. We can get Massimo's Crash Hammer, which has a 20% crit strike. Lower hit ratio, but you know what, it'll make up for it in the long run. Get Marino's Beam Chakras. Get Cinnamon's Metal Boxer. And we already have the Queen of Hearts, that's fine, we got everything else. As far as these goes, I am going to buy two Twin Missiles, because I'm going to need, not Twin Missiles, Ice Missiles, because the next dungeon is, for all intents and purposes, going to be a Fire Dungeon. So that's that, that's good. Item shop-wise, I don't think he has anything new. I think the backup is new. I think that's new. I don't remember if he sold that last chapter or not, but this is what he has, good for him. If you need anything old, there's your general shop right there. I will be going to places in between videos in order to level up my characters. And let's go to the Force Metal shop. What do you got? Fire Guard, of course, to prepare us for the next level. LE-300. Now she's starting to sell the plus 3. So you can get power plus 3, armor, shield, speed. Gain weapon energy plus 5, which I'm actually going to buy another one of those. I like the Protex. The Protex are actually pretty good for Cinnamon. And full specs ones, I'll actually buy one of those for right now. And we'll leave it at that. Okay. So, before I actually go around and equip everybody, why don't we talk about our brand new member to the group. She is right there on the bottom, joining us at a horrible level 1, Cinnamon. Let's go to her equipment screen. Cinnamon is a C-type attacker, so she's going to run at you and slap you back and forth with her hands. Depending on what gloves she is wearing, she will do different effects. Right now she has the Angel's Hands, which is pretty much just her normal attack. It doesn't do anything special. Metal Boxers, on the other hand, have a high crit percentage, and it also increases her evasion by 15%. Also notice these are both 2 hits, and she'll actually gain more hits depending on what item she has equipped. Also, her armor and her shield go down pretty extreme with the metal boxers, so you want to make sure to compensate that with other force metals that boost it up. That's why I wanted that Protect one, but I'll be able to sell stuff and buy it a little bit later. As far as her sub-weapon, she comes equipped with the Energy Field, a Cinnamon-only weapon. You will actually be able to get one more of these, I believe, later on, so she can equip 2. And when she uses it, she uses 10 of her own weapon energy, or 20 of her own weapon energy, to give everybody on the field 10. So in a sense, this only costs her 10 weapon energy to give everybody 10, because she gains back the 10 as well. You can equip another one, so, I mean, yeah, she'll be using the weapon energy for it, but the fact that she'll be able to give weapon energy to other characters is an absolute must. I am, however, going to give her... I'll give it the twin missiles. Why not? Okay, as far as force metals go, I don't think, yeah, she doesn't come equipped with anything, but her immunity is really high. She's at a 20 already at level 1. I mean, Marino, here's Marino, at level 17, she's at a 20. You know, so, even she has a higher one than Spider, and Spider's at level 18. So she has a very high immunity, and this will just keep gaining with her as she goes on. I am gonna give her the weapon energy plus 5, because she really needs the weapon energy for all of her special techniques. We'll throw a Protect plus 1, and then I did buy a full spec one, there it is. Oh, and I'm actually even right there, so... yeah, we'll leave it like that for right now. When I go and I level her up in between chapters, I'll get enough money and build her immunity up higher to give her a Protect plus 3 or whatever it is. Alright, before I go over the Force Metal Generator, why don't we actually go into her status screen itself. So as you can see, she takes half damage from all elements. Hooray! Finally somebody that's not weak against an element. In fact, she's strong against all of them. She has pretty okay stats per se. Again, she's level 1 here, so she's a bit different. As far as her hyper or her action trigger goes, you build up the weapon energy and you use it. It's called Angelic Aid. You rotate the C-stick to create a basic party heal technique. Starts off at a max of 40% of your maximum LE. So when you're actually spinning the C-stick, 4 hearts will appear on the screen. Once all 4 hearts appear, the action trigger ends, and everybody is healed 40%. As she levels up, she will gain more hearts to the point where she'll be able to 100% heal everybody on your side of the team. So besides some tanks, Cinnamon is 100% your best choice for healing. I mean, she's a healer. What else did you expect her to do? She's a nurse. Look at her. That's what she does. Let's rotate her. She's a nurse. I like the gloves. Those are with the gloves. So you're going to see she puts on different gloves as you get them throughout the game. The more weapon energy you pump into it, the more time you have to rotate the C-stick. But if you're fast enough at it, you can hit 100% heal at 50% weapon energy and be at that. Her hyper mode is called Iron Maiden. And besides her rocking out with Eddie the Head, she also gains a 50% life energy boost, power by 50% as well. And the ability to give all allies an additional, I believe it's 25% weapon energy per turn. So as long as she's in Iron Maiden, everybody else on the team gains an additional weapon energy of 25% per turn. No changes to the sub-weapons or the action trigger, but what she does turn into is, and I'm going to kind of just flip this back and forth a little bit, nurse, maid. Nurse, maid. Yeah, she's like 14, guys. I mean, come on. She even has, like, you know, the legs and the garters and, come on. I, like other guys, I am not one to, you know, pass up a good nurse or a good maid type of mind fantasy thing, whatever, but come on, she's 14. Either way, she looks pretty badass, personally, as the Iron Maiden, so that is Cinnamon. Now, as far as what she brings to the table, other than just her being her, is the Force Metal Generator. In here, we are able to make Force Metals now at our own leisure, but of course, things need to happen in order for us to have the right requirements. The number one thing is the required level in order to make things. Cinnamon will be able to make stronger Force Metals as she gains levels, and being level one, you can't make anything. So let's just kind of go over this. Here we go. Taking the very first one, for example, LE plus 100. On the right side, you're going to see the recipe. This is what you need in order. This is the conditions you need to make in order to be able to actually make this particular force metal. So first off, required level 5. Cinnamon needs to be at least level 5 for her to be able to make this force metal. Second thing you need is a set amount of force metal energy. Remember, I've been talking about this pretty much almost every episode as we've been going along. Well, all that force metal energy they've been collecting throughout the entire game that has been stacking, that I currently have now, and I'll show you when I'm done with this, has finally accumulated into, well, it's there on the bottom, actually, 6,538 force metal energy I've been collecting so far. I will need 100 of it in order to make this. In addition to that, you'll need specific ingredients in order to make this specific, this force metal. So I would need at least one reboot, which I have, that's why it's white, and I would need one weapon energy plus 5. Technically I have it, but it's equipped the spider, so I can't use it. That's why it's gray and you can still see the one. So that is what you need in order to make the life energy plus 100 force metal. And each one of these, force metals has their own set of conditions in order to get. So here we have right here. It has all blue question marks. That means that we had the ability to make this force metal, but we don't know what it is. We got the recipe because we were able to hit a certain set of conditions that unlocked the recipe. What do I mean by that? Take this for example. Conditions for obtaining recipe. Fight at least 250 battles. When we hit 250 battles, like this one where it shows us the requirements, force metal, and ingredients, this will then become available to us. So that's the way that you unlock new things mostly. And there's different conditions. So this is battles. Down here is, let's see, that's battles, play hours, inflict damage per turn. What else we got? Total enemies defeated. So there's a bunch of things that you can do throughout the game. Here's the weapons, that's what I'm saying. Collect as many weapons as possible so you can get the increase of stuff. And if you can tell, they're all kind of the same, so you have speed plus 1, obviously this is going to be speed plus 3, this is speed, because they're all together. So you want to make sure to gain as many weapons as possible so you can get the better speed force metals. And there's just so many of these that you can go through the entire game and really try to find all the different conditions that you need in order to be able to make them. And then at your leisure, just kind of make the best force metals and attach them onto your characters as you see fit. There's other things in here like, let's see. There was a few. I know I passed it. Is it? No. Let's see. Come on. Where are you? Melt missiles. There's a lot of crazy stuff in here. Unrefinable. I know there's one up here. Let me go back up that way. I believe it's Massimo's. The exclusive force metals for the characters are considered unrefinable. They're only gotten through special conditions in the game. Like, for example, when Massimo joined our party, he had his... Okay, so take Marino's. Here you go. The fat slicer. The only way we get this is by it being equipped to Marina when she first came into our party. So do not sell this. You will never need it for any type of like a refinement or things along that ways. So you have it. It's there. Other ways that you unlock recipes are simply by buying the force metal. If I were to go and buy the shield plus 3, for example, this will automatically open up for me. I will have the recipe. I won't need to have defeated 30 enemy types. I would just have the force metal, it would tell me the recipe, and that's that. So, anytime I'm in the force metal shop, and I see new force metals, and I have the Zenny, which I will shortly, I will just buy them, since I have the recipe in order to open them up. Also, keep in mind, on the side, the higher versions of these, so take speed, for example. I believe it goes up to plus 10, I believe is the highest one it goes to. When you hit speed plus 10, as part of your ingredient, you will need a build speed. So a lot of these are going to start needing the build items as well, which is why I told you, once you start collecting them, you might as well just hang on to them, because you're going to need them for better force metals, and in the long run, it's better to have the force metal than to increase your character's speed by 1. I don't know. I'd rather do it by 10 than 1, even if it costs, you know, whatever. Plus, there's so many places to get builds in the game and whatnot, and again, like I said before, you don't really need them in order to beat the game. You want to build up your characters, great. The only build you really need is build Hyper. There's only 12 of them in the game. I told you, once you grab it, hold on to it. Do not give it to Spider. Sorry, I just have to inform that right now. Do not give any builds to Spider. And then otherwise that, I mean, you can use them if you want to, but I say hold on to them. And that's pretty much it. In between episodes, I am going to level up Cinnamon in order to try to get her some Force Metal's ability to be made. And then that's pretty much going to be that. This is how it is for Force Metal. If I make something important, or I make something good or interesting or anything along that ways, I will go in and I will show it. But otherwise that, then I'll just kind of make them as I go along. So that's that. That was Cinnamon. That was the Force Metal generator. And that was all the items that we kind of currently need right now. Why don't we take the time to go here and, yeah, sure, why not? Let's actually use the vending machine and see what this is all about. We have 27 tokens. We should be able to get 2 full series. They do give them to you in order that you've gone through the game. So this is Chapter 1, Chapter 2, Chapter 3, Chapter 4. So why don't we just start with Shadow's Betrayal and see what we got. Drop in 2, and we get the Hip Oppressor. Cool. Oh, I love this boss. He's so cool. Look at him. Just big and crazy. And all right, good. Moving right along, 5 more to complete the series, still plenty to go. Let's drop another 2 into Shadow's Betrayal, and we get Shadow himself. I mean, Shadow is cool. I like Shadow, as you know. And I think Shadow was supposed to be Vile. I don't know if that's for sure or not, but just like his character design reminds me a little bit of Vile from the X series. And if you can't tell by now, sorry, spoiler alert, Vile is not in this game anywhere. Neither is Sigma, but we're going against Epsilon, so, you know, Greek letters and etc. like that. I believe it's Greek, right? Sure, why not? So, no Sigma, Epsilon, no Vile, Shadow. Next, 4 more to complete the series. Keep collecting, and I shall. And we get X himself as a figure. Really cool in his battle stance. 3 more to complete the series. Halfway there. Ooh. Next, we put in 2 more, and we get a Batbone. Nice and a cool character from the original X series and everything along that ways. Keep moving along. 2 more to complete the series. Almost done. We are very close. And we got Epsilon in his cape. So obviously based off of that, there will be different versions of Epsilon we will be able to collect throughout the game. So this is him in his cool little cloak that he wears to make himself look, you know, more BA than he already is, I guess. With those weird wires hanging out in the back of him and whatnot. And that's the stance he was in when he blocked X's buster shot, so that's pretty cool. 1 more to complete the series. The goal is just around the corner. And in fact, we are there right now. The last one in Shadow's Betrayal is a patrol dog! Yes! We love the little guy. He's been giving us a lot of stuff. Moving right along to the next series. It's sold out, so now if you ever go into it, it'll just tell you it's sold out. But it stays on there, so don't just keep hitting A rapidly. You're going to have to actually go down to the next series in order to collect one. So, the Bounty Hunters. Let's start. We get Wild Django as our first one. Our very first official boss based off of a, I want to say it's a leopard, right? Because a Django is not an animal, I guess. I don't know. I didn't really look this one up because he's a cat. That's that. Moving along. 5 more to complete the series. Next, Bounty Hunters. We got our Captain Chief as Django would say, because apparently he was part pirate, which I guess would make sense here because he has a parrot on his shoulder. Yeah, we'll go with that. 4 more to complete the series. Next one in the series is Spider! He's ready to go, ready to hit you with his cool little card-throwing techniques. Because if you look underneath those little things sticking out from his, I guess the wrist, that's where he fires out a bunch of cards from. Then you can see the 2 little slots that are about the size of cards that he'll kind of fire them off at you like a machine gun thing. You'll also notice that he'll fire out of them when he goes into his 2-hit combo animation. So, Spider! Nice. 3 more to go halfway through the series. Next one. Ooh, so excited. Who is it? Who is it? Oh, it's Rowdy Reploid. Oh, is that what your name is? It's Mr. Lockjaw, the guy that attempted to turn us into the Rebellion Army when we first got here, and then Spider threw a card at him and made him blow up in 1 shot. It's kind of sad that he's gone completely, but now he will forever be immortalized in this figure. 2 more to go to complete the series, whatever. Almost done. Next. Here we go. The Bounty Hunters. Ooh, who are we going to get next? Uh, And the last one, we go to the Bounty Hunters for the final character in the series, the Citizen Dreploid, the guy that we see all over the place, just recolored everywhere we go. So that's pretty much that. All right, Bounty Hunter series is complete. That being that, I think there's only, what else we got? Massimo's Vow and Generator Revealed. So you can kind of guess Massimo will be in this, so it'll be Silverhorn, Marino and Cinnamon, I believe, are in here, plus Psych, plus Mad Nautilus, so I don't know who the other ones would be. I think they're both in those. I don't remember. Doesn't really matter. Again, those are just for, you know, your own personal enjoyment in order to collect and have fun with and then do whatever it is you want to do. Let's head back to our command center. I don't think the deployments are back yet, but might as well just take a look. Let's take a look-see. Alright, Miss Nana, let us see what you got. Call the deployment center and... anybody return? Oh, we had a few return. Let's see. So, Central Tower is still out there. Oh, no. Central Tower returned, and we have Tiana Camp and Lingaro still out. So, let's see how they did. All right. Okay. Preon went up. His search went up. Very nice. Sign Dropper went up, finally. So, now his search also went up. And Big Monkey came back. He didn't level up, but you know what? All three of them came back alive. That, to me, is great. I'm very happy with that result. And we got... music, a figure token, I believe these are art, and that is also music, and 408 Zenny. Hoorah, and all that in between. Let's go back here, let us go... do I want to send a... you know what? Let's go to Galdeen. Let us take the Preon, the Sign Dropper, and the Big Monkey, and we'll send them to Galdeel's Laboratory. She's worried, but I am not. I think they'll be okay, and if anybody dies, then... whoops. Alright, and that's that. Good, good, good. Finish deployment. Yes, I will. Disconnect. And that, as they say, is that. So, yeah, I'm going to end right here. Rate, comment, subscribe, as I ask you to do with almost every YouTube episode. I thank you guys for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one, where we will actually move forward with the story. We will go into Chapter 5. I want to say it's the Olaf Factory? I don't know. Whatever. And, we'll see what's new there. Again, that's the fire dungeon, so equip your ice stuff. And in between episodes, I will build up my cinnamon. So, until next time, everybody, I shall catch you all later.